Well, here we are, done at last. This is what I've been kind of calling the homemade Victor II. Whoa, kind of looks like one, and it's about the same size, sort of, kind of. What this is a homemade horn machine built from the cabinet and motor and turntable and various other parts of a Victrola the Fourth. A 1911, a very early 1912 model. I don't know who built it. I suspect it was built 40, 50, 60 years ago. It's hard to say. The majority of the parts used are from Victor phonographs, with certain things that were homemade. I do not know who made the horn. It could be Victor. I don't know this. I'm pretty sure that the decal is a reproduction, because you can see where this horn was sprayed black over old paint that had been peeling and such. They never removed the old paint, just sprayed over it, and the decal is applied on top of that, so you can see the pock marks of the old paint right through the decal. That would not have been the case had that been original. There's a reproduction aluminum tone on elbow, which fits very well, works perfectly, very nice job whoever did it. Those things are sometimes a little hard to come by, but you can see where the entire turn-on bracket assembly has been very creatively made from the parts of the Victrola 4, and it works. It actually was built by somebody who understood some of the basic principles of how a phonograph works. It tracks at least as good as the Victrola 4 tracks, and probably slightly better than the Victor 2 is known to track. Oak cabinet has had these little corner pieces added to it for effect. And you can see that the horn opening of the Victrola the Fourth is gone. When it came to me, this thing, the motor was broken. The previous video covers what I did to the motor. Essentially, I had to put a new mainspring in it. The spring was snapped. The governor had flown itself to pieces. I had to replace that. And because it was the old style governor, horn machine era style governor for like the aughts, I modified it to use an improved motor governor and brass gear, and it worked just fine. That's all working good. The motor is excellent. No problems there. It came with a Victrola number 2 reproducer that was pretty rough. It needed everything. It needed diaphragm gaskets, front and back. It needed the springs. It needed the whole needle bar had to be straightened. It was quite an involved job with that. And now it's working perfectly. There's no problems with it. The owner of this, I do not own this machine. As I said in previous videos, I'm doing this for somebody else. And they requested that I find a way to get rid of what was being used for the front panel here, which was essentially just, where are they? The doors from the Victor 4, you see, just a Victor, they were just mounted on there with a big seam in the middle. He wanted to get rid of that seam. That was the most difficult part of this whole operation. And he wanted to move the brass plaque from the side to the front of the machine like it would be on a horn machine. Which, that part was easy. I left it dark. I did not polish that plaque, the ID plate, because from a distance across the room, yeah, it'll pass for a horn machine one, kind of, sort of. I searched around to try to find a panel to put here. This is an oak machine, as they all are, that old Victrola the Fourths are. I did not have anything that would fit the space that was the right size. And I wasn't going to bust up another Victrola to try to make something for that. So I actually had to travel over into Connecticut and have a piece of wood made to fit this out of red oak. And I am not a cabinet maker. I'm not a carpenter. I rarely do more with wood repair than gluing a little veneer down or gluing a corner joint or something like that. You know, this is a little outside of what I normally do, so it took quite a bit longer than I had expected. I had to acquire tools I did not have to do the job. There was a lot of glue stuck to these corner pieces and to the machine itself from when these were originally attached, and I bought a palm sander, right? A Ryobi palm sander, because, well, one thing, I had batteries for those, for my other Ryobi tools, so, and that took care of the job of getting that off. And not only that, there was, not epoxy, that's the wrong word, definitely the wrong word. There was caulking. Somebody had used caulking. I guess these pieces had fallen off over the years, and they put caulking on these, and off on, under here, on three of these anyway, that had fallen off, and stuck them back on with caulking. Let me tell you what, it is not easy to get that caulking off, especially not when it's down in the grain. That was quite a job. We got it out though, what a mess. And this panel is now a solid, well, this whole machine is a solid box now. What else? Oh yes. Whoever built this machine also put some kind of coating over what I suspect is the original finish. You can always tell when it's been coated with something. One, got a kind of a matte finish to it. It's a little shinier than it should be. And you can see the open grain. I'm not sure how well that's showing up on camera. The open grain in there. Now, Victor did not send these out of the factory like that. They had a process where they filled in the open grain. Some special stuff they used that even included seaweed, I understand, to fill those in. Well, they didn't do that when they recovered this, and it's probably, I don't know if it's poly or it's some kind of lacquer finish on there, clear lacquer. I know it's not shellac, I know that, because I was unable to lighten this or do anything to it. I wanted to try to lighten it because this front panel was a lighter color, and I had a heck of a time darkening that wood to try to get it to match. It's close now. You know, it's as good as I'm going to get it anyway. Like I said, it's not what I usually do. You know, I'm sure those out there who routinely repair cabinetry and furniture and whatnot are saying, oh, there's an easy way to do that. This is how you do it. Well, that's not really what I do. I'm more of a motors guy. I work on the motor. I know how to clean a wood finish and not disturb the original finish. That I know how to do pretty well. But I don't refinish things normally. I'm not equipped to do it. I don't have the facilities for it. I'm not trained to do it. So, you know, I didn't want to have to strip this whole machine down. And if I did that, it would end up costing my customer a lot of money because there's a tremendous amount of time involved in that. But I did manage to get that panel on there. It's all set now. I did manage to get the machine playing. It's got the last thing I had to do was put the little rubber feet under there because the old ones were all rock hard and at different heights, you know, and the machine was wobbly. So I put brand new ones on there, and we are ready to go. We are now going to commence testing records. I've already been playing it, so I know, I suspected from the start this would play and play well, and it does. You know, I suspect, like I said before in the earlier video, I think this was made for a theater production or a set dressing of some kind, motion pictures, television, who knows what, because it's a little too elaborate, I think, for the average cobbled together homemade contraption. This was intended to be able to play a record well, you know. Maybe that was part of whatever they were doing. They needed to have it play at some point, so they did that. That's the only thing I really didn't have to mess with, was that back bracket. That was in good shape. Everything was good there. Didn't have to do anything to that. So whoever did that did a very good job. Really all they did was take a piece of pipe. They cut some holes in it, and they took off the tone arm support there on top, the crane, flipped it over somehow, and mounted the tone arm upside down. And it works. It definitely works. And they just attached the other end of that pipe to the lower part of the tone arm elbow. Hey, you know, it does actually do the job. This will never be a real horn machine, but it is... You know, it is a machine that plays records well. At least you have that. At least it does do that. It will play records. And because this horn is considerably larger than what was inside the case of this, it does play a lot louder than your average Victrola the Fourth will play. So that this has that too. It is pretty loud. Okay. Speed has been set. What do we got here? I just picked out some records, look fairly clean, but they got a little bit of wear on them. You know, that's okay, because when you're testing a motor, you do want a little bit of wear. Oh, Katharina, Billy Murray. Let's try Billy. Let's see. Also had to fix the brake. Things on the floor. Yeah. Okay. She plays good. You can see it still has the original flat crank, flat shank crank, female crank on there. And you got to, these wind about seven, because it's the older style motor, it winds about 17 times from flat to full. So you don't want to overwind it. Even with a brand new spring, don't ever overwind a Victrola. When you feel resistance, you stop. That's all. Here we got some more rain falling, hopefully. This machine's loud enough you can hear it over the rain. I've been trying to get this video made all day, but the rain was not cooperating. Okay. Wind it back up again, and we'll be good to go for... Oh, we got to turn the record over, don't we? That would help. Unless we hear an El Catarina again. We have... Don't bring Lulu! A few scratches and pucks on there, but I think she'll play.
Don't bring Lulu! presence is requested, wrote little Johnny White. But with this invitation, there is a stipulation. When you attend this party, you'll all be treated right. But there's a wild and woolly woman you boys can't invite. You can bring Pearl, she's a darn nice girl, but don't bring Lulu. You can bring Rose with a turned up nose, but don't bring Lulu. Lulu always wants to do what the folks don't want her to. When she thrusts her stuff around, London Bridge is falling down. You can bring cake for a porterhouse steak, but don't bring Lulu. Lulu gets blue and goes cuckoo like the clock upon the shelf. She's the kind of party, breaks up every party. Colorful Lulu, don't bring Lulu, I'll bring her myself. We had a party, a real high-toned affair. And then along came Lulu, wild as any Zulu. She started into Charleston and how the boys did stare. But when she did the hula hula, then she got the air. You can bring Flo, her dad got dough, but don't bring Lulu. You can bring Mill, she's an awful kill, but don't bring Lulu. Lulu has the reddest hair, auburn here and henna there. How can we boys keep our heads? Bulls go wild when they see red. You can bring peas and colors and cheese, but don't bring Lulu. When she gets sore and slams the door, the place fly off the shelf. She can make a fella wild on sarsaparilla. Hullabaloo Lulu, don't bring Lulu, she'll come here herself. Don't bring Lulu. Don't bring Lulu. You can bring ham and crackers and jam, but don't bring Lulu. Lulu goes wild, and when she's wild, she climbs upon the shelf. She can make a passer, be a dancing master. Full of a Lulu, don't bring Lulu, I'll bring her myself.
Don't bring Lulu. Okay. What do we got next? We got a new needle. Okay. Hopefully the rain now is just on a roof. I'm not going to ruin the sound, but I don't think it will. It's pretty loud. Except I'm not as familiar with this camera as I am with my other one. I don't know exactly how the microphone reacts to such noises. Okay, what's the next record? Come on, let's not break anything here. Tain't nobody's business if I do. The Tennessee Ten. Okay. With single spring motors like this, always wind it between plays. They have small springs. Yeah, it'll probably do two plays because it is a new spring. But records vary in length and time. Some are 4 minutes, some are 2.5, you know. So you may not be able to get a full play out of a record, out of a single wind, if you try to do both sides of the record at once on one wind anyway. Okay, this we got a little bit of wobble in that one. Not that big a deal.
Thank you.
play pretty well. It's just a little wobbly, but that can easily be fixed. The trick to that is you take two pieces of glass bigger than the record. You put the record between the two pieces of glass and set the glass and the records on top of a car or some other thing, a table, whatever, in the sunlight. And you stay there and watch it. Don't ever leave it alone. Stay there and watch it. And you'll see that the heat coming through the glass will gently push the record down until it's flat on the other piece of glass. Then you take it off the sun and your record is now fixed. At least the warp is fixed. It will do nothing for cracks. So don't, or wear, or anything like that. It's not a magic fix. It's only a fix for warpage, which happens when records are stored for 100 years in a hot attic somewhere, standing on end or something like that, and maybe in albums or something, and they get just warped a little bit. Very common thing to see. Okay, let's tighten that down. Now what's on the other side? Flip side, we have Waiting for the Evening Mail. Again, the Tennessee 10. Which I assume they were from Tennessee. Maybe. Maybe not. Who knows? Victor was pressing so many groups back then. It's impossible to keep track of all of them. You always got to be careful too with these flat shank cranks. They do have a tendency to snap the weld right there at the bottom. And then you're either trying to weld it back or you're simply trying to find another crank. Not that that's hard to find, but still irritating when it happens. So always treat them gently. Don't abuse them. Remember, these things are very, very old.
Thank you.
side played pretty good too. Let's see what we got next. Seems that the rain has ceased for the moment. Let's see, let's get another needle. Good way to get stabbed doing it one-handed, but I'm a one-man show here. Lovey Dove, the Club Royal Orchestra. Another warpy one. Look at that. Jumping all over the place. Bit more worn than they appear to be. That's all right. Being that it has a brand new mainspring, I'm more interested in functioning the motor than in trying to stress it. I know the spring is good on this one. Okay, just want to make sure everything's holding together and it's going to be okay for the customer. So far, I've played, other than these, probably 20 more other records on here. No problems, and I'm going to play probably 20 more when I'm done with these. Just to make sure everything stays good. Whoops. I forgot to turn the record over. Two. You can have every light on. The International Novelty Orchestra. Number 18889-A. A lot of eights there. I did not buff out the tone arm. I've left it in its natural toned. That's nickel plated, by the way. Natural nickel toning on there. There's some kind of coating on there they've put, and I don't want to mess with it. So, and there's no chance in hell I'm ever going to get it to match the aluminum color up there. So I will leave it as it is, and if the customer decides they want to play with it in the future, they can, but I'm not going to leave. I am going to leave it alone. And let's see, what's the next record? I got one more here. That was three we played. Yeah. One more record here. Let's see. Sweetheart, Paul Whitman and his orchestra.